name is John DiLeo. I decided that my title was conference chair a while ago. I guess basically I'm the lead organizer, the one who's working on the conference all year instead of just for 2 or 3 months. So the instructions there, I can see there's still some seats in the room, so it's not too big a deal, but for the start of day, through the keynote speech, and then we have a short wrap-up this afternoon, and then we've got a recap of the welcome session tomorrow morning, especially for people attending only tomorrow. All of those, the start and end sessions, are also being sent to the WA220 room. So if we do fill up this space, you can go find a seat down there. It also, you may have noticed, is true that everything going on in this room is showing up on the video wall out by the sponsor exhibit area. And there are speakers up on the third floor terrace overlooking the exhibition area. So if you feel like just kind of grabbing a coffee and chilling out for a while, you can go there and at least watch track one. But if you're hardcore and you want to do the track two talks, well, you have to go downstairs. So basic health and safety, and of course I forgot to ask the event team what I'm supposed to say, so I guess I'll just make it up. In the event of an emergency, flee. In that case, that means go to the nearest exit, proceed calmly out of the building. Our designated assembly area is the courtyard space outside the exit by the cafe toward Mayoral Drive. So, go out the nearest exit of the room, proceed to a ground floor, or to a ground level exit, and then make your way to the assembly point. That's not my phone, because I forgot to bring it with me. All right, a little bit about toilets. So I'm standing at, well, this is actually the mezzanine, because we're 4 steps above level 3. But on level 3, there are a number of toilets. It's just, people are always wondering where they are. So you may have noticed that there's one toilet next to the Newsfeed Cafe. The rest of the level 3 toilets are on the other side of the radio station. So if you're on level 3, you go around the red room, the radio station, and down the corridor on the other side, you'll find the men's and women's toilets are there. Down on level 2, they're tucked under the balcony behind Cardi McCartface. On level 4, so if you go out the back door here, then they're roughly above the ones on level 3. I'm not sure exactly the path to get there. You go across the open area. We have lots of toilets. Also, on level 2, if you go past the exhibitors and then down the corridor to your right, you'll find sets of toilets. So I think we're covered. Water. Drink water. Please stay hydrated. It's surprising because some of these, so few places in New Zealand are air-conditioned, and then you spend some time in an air-conditioned or heated space, you don't realize how quickly you dry out. So hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. Use water if you can't get coffee. Wow, that took a minute. Is it really that early? Now that coffee hasn't kicked in. First aid. We do actually have a couple of certified first aiders on the volunteer team. Although we're supposed to have the venue staff deal with things at each of the information desks, so at the WG3 lobby as well as down at the sponsor check-in desk, we do have some basic supplies. So if you need a plaster or some, a couple of, what are they called here, paracetamols? Tylenols. Then we've got those basic things. We also have some basic comfort and hygiene supplies if anyone finds that they need those. So just drop by the desk and ask for it. We should have it. The conference has a fairly straightforward code of conduct. If you're wondering if you should say that, don't say that. I know that's oversimplification, but basically, do not be one of those people. So, we take harassment complaints seriously. first port of call would be either myself or Annika. So talk to us. We'll work to resolve the issue. In the event of something really serious, we'll get campus security and or the police involved as necessary. If you're going to be the sort of person that we need to have that kind of conversation with, then you're not welcome. That's a pretty straightforward policy. If you have other issues, come see one of the blue shirts. We'll do what we can to help you out. The point is to have this be an informative and enjoyable experience for you today and tomorrow. So if you're finding that that's not happening for you, talk to us and we'll see what we can do. Okay. I swear that QR code is that URL. So if you're watching on the live stream, congratulations, you sorted it out. For those of you who are here in person, if you would like to catch a stream session, maybe while you're having a coffee or while you're putting together Legos, then you can go to the SCED website, and then each of the sessions has its own Vimeo stream on its page. I installed the SCED app last night. It works just fine. So if you install the SCED app, or I guess maybe we would call it Shed here, then you can connect to the OWASP 2023 event and sign in with the email address you used to register for the conference, because that's the one that's been invited. And then you'll have access to the event and can view all the live streams, set up your schedule, and so on. In addition, take the recordings from each talk, and after they've been cleaned up and trimmed, they will get uploaded to the OWASP New Zealand Chapter's YouTube channel. If you didn't know we had a YouTube channel, shame on you. It's an incredibly active channel. It has videos from 6 conferences. All right. If it's an OWASP event, I have to take some time to talk about OWASP. It's the law. If you're not familiar with OWASP, then perk up and pay attention. I also noticed I forgot to edit this slide. OWASP is the Open Worldwide Application Security Project. Change from web to worldwide was effective mid-February this year. And I did not edit the slide. So it's a global community-supported project, and our focus is on improving the security of software in general. But obviously, we started with web applications, and these days, there's very little that is not technically a web application. So it's pretty much everything. It's managed by the OWASP Foundation with a volunteer global board of directors, and you can find us at OWASP.org. So we have well over 250 chapters worldwide, various levels of activity at different times, and around 200 projects, including our 17 famous flagship projects. Who has heard of the OWASP Top 10? Okay. Who has ever used an Apache server with mod security enabled? Just a few hands. How about OWASP SAM? Oh, even fewer hits. That hurts. I'm a core member of the OWASP SAM project team, and I was hoping I'd see a lot of hands. It's obvious that I'm not basically alternating hotels. So they'll be in D.C. next year, then back at the San Francisco hotel that we're at in November in 2025, and then back to D.C. in 26 and so on. So book your flights now. And we do lots of regional and local conferences and training events like this one. Now, OWASP New Zealand was founded in 2007, so just a few years after OWASP. The OWASP New Zealand Day Conference has been going on since 2009, and some of the conference organizers of yore are in the back of the room, are in the room. So I see Kirk's right here up front, and I assume Luck is somewhere in the room. So this has been an event that's gone on, it's grown, and we've made it bigger and tried to do more fancy things, and sometimes said, oh, that was not a good choice, let's stop doing that. Retrospectives are good. But it's volunteer run, and it's here for the community to help educate technical people, so developers, security professionals, and so on, in looking at application security and improving the security of New Zealand's software. We have a student-focused conference that we've done a couple of times, and maybe we can manage to do one again this year. We'll see. We have the meetups, the Auckland meetup I've been leading since March of 2018, and we meet 5 times a year. So those are the dates out to March of next year. I went and I checked the meetup pages for the Wellington and Christchurch, and these are the last dates that they had events listed. Now, there's been a slight change. I often stand up and I say, hey, go to the InfoSec NZ Slack. Get someone to let you in there, because that's where we do our conversing. InfoSec NZ Slack is now legacy. InfoSec NZ Discord is where it's at. So you can join the conversation there. You can also get involved in the OWASP Slack. And that URL takes you to a page which has a single text box on it. Put a valid email address in and click the submit button. That will generate concerned in WA-224B. So as you're heading down the corridor toward the Track 2 room, the first set of wooden doors is 224A. Those are locked. If you want to go into the delegate lounge, go through the exhibit area. Then the next set of doors is 224B. It's just on the other side of the catering kitchen. And then the next set of doors is 220, where the track is. So go in there, 224B, between noon and 1:30 with your ticket, and we'll get you sorted for lunch. If you didn't get a chance to order lunch or you just didn't feel like it, well, there's lots else you can do, including the Newsfeed Cafe is open. And honestly, I like their soup. As I said, please abide by our code of conduct. We have a lot of other stuff to do, so it would be really nice not to have to deal with code of conduct issues. Please. Another thing to bear in mind, the rooms will be live all day. So if you're in this room, or if you're in WA-220, or in the demo room, 404, act as though you're on a live mic, okay? If you would not want it broadcast on somebody's blog, don't say it in the room. The exceptions are when, in the demo room, when we've explicitly said it's not being streamed, or there's not a session active, then the cameras won't be active. Okay, so the delegate lounge. So who worked on the Legos last year? Wow, okay. Like six people in the room. Well, I like Legos, so we're doing it again this year. But we're doing something different. So last year we tried to fit into the 2 days of the conference the construction of the Ultimate Collector Series Millennium Falcon, and we got about three quarters of the way through. I guess there just wasn't enough time. Oh, and there was that whole thing about one giant instruction manual. So what we're trying this year is that we have the Lego build table set up so that you can have up to four pairs of people working on sets. So there can be four different sets being built, and we have 14 sets to build. And they're all cars. Because, cars. It's also because that's something that Lego currently has a variety of. So we've got a couple of fun sets. My son is in the Lego room, and he decided we're starting with the Batmobile. So that should be underway now. And we've got a couple of the classic cars and then some of the smaller sets. Now, how does this figure into your life? Well, first, if you like to build Legos, go check it out. Did I get the time right? 8 to... Okay, well, that's the delegate. So the delegate lounge is open from 9 to 6 and from 8 to 4. That's 224A. The Lego build has only slightly different registration desk, the information counter, and then down at the sponsor check-in desk. So after you've gotten all 9 stamps, clearly print your real name and a valid email address and drop the card in a fishbowl. In addition, some of the sponsors will be doing their own prize draws. So if they have something at their table and they would like you to fill out an entry form, they set the terms and conditions for those draws. So for each of the sponsor booth draws, they set the terms and conditions. They might have you fill out a slip of paper or enter online. Do so if you choose to. And then they will either do a draw at their booth at Friday afternoon tea, or they'll come forward during closing session and do the draw live. I thought I had. Did I just go buy it? Oh, there it was. Okay. So the top bullet, I skipped right over it. So the top prize draw in the door prizes is every completed set. So the more you build, the bigger the top prizes. However, every set that does not get finished by 3:30 tomorrow will be a separate prize. Game that as you see fit. Okay, our conference structure. We've got 2 tracks, and then we also have the demo/breakout track. This is track 1. WA220 is track 2, and up on level 4, on that side of this room is WG404. It's a case study room, and that's where the demos and breakouts will be. You have a printed program in your swag bag. The conference schedule is up. There have been a couple of corrections. The schedule is up to date and correct both on SCED and on our website. And you'll see posted schedules around the venue, which should have a couple of stickers on them to correct some times. Oh, yeah, that is important. If you're entering a session during a talk or during a scheduled session time, be sure to do so quietly. And in this room, after the session begins, please do not enter these doors. Go up to level 4, go in the back doors. All right, just a couple of program changes for today. Unfortunately, Sarah Young was unable to travel to Auckland. So we've basically switched our first 2 talks in track 1 after the keynote, so that we are at least starting with an in-person talk and begin to put Kirk on the spot. So he'll, at 10:55, be doing an OWASP Top 10 Overview talk, and then we'll have Sarah join us, and she'll present her fantastic cloud security mistakes and where to find them talk at 11:30 from home. We've also added another breakout session this afternoon. So at 3:30, Daniel Zollinger, who's one of the members of the Aotearoa Tech Union's Leadership Committee, he'll be holding an information session to talk about the union, its mission, why as a tech worker you might want to be a member of a union. Well, and obviously ours is the best, so you want to be part of that union. So he'll be there to answer your questions, give you information, and improve awareness. In general, we have 3 demos in the demo room this fine day. So at 1:30, Defend is leading a session to talk about careers in security. That is not going to be streamed, it's not going to be recorded. 2:25, our friends from Fastly will be having a discussion about hand coding security at the edge. And then the information session for ATU is at 3:30. We do have some old merch available for sale. So after lunch, starting at 1:30 at the Level 2 desk, you can pick up some merch. We have old conference t-shirts dating back to 2020. Whatever we have is still available for $5 each. We also have about 10 elevation and privilege decks left. So these are the boxed decks that we had printed 2 years ago, I believe. So they're $19 a set. And because we had some backdoors and breaches decks, we had 50 decks and 100 dice. We still have some dice available. So if you need a D20, it's a dollar. I'm telling you today so you can make your plans for tomorrow. Okay. The post-conference gathering is at Galbraith's Ale House, which is, I should have looked it up, I think it's like number 13 or number 11, Mount Eden Road. So from here, you basically go to the end of Simon Street and turn left. So tomorrow afternoon from 5:15, we have some tables booked. If you get there before we do, which you probably will, just ask for the OWASP tables. And I'll point it out, this is a self-hosted event. You might be able to find a sponsor or two who are happy to shout rounds, but there is not a conference tab, so just come out and share some fellowship with one another and have a couple of drinks, some lovely, lovely bar food on you. Okay. The next order of business, this is an important one, is we want to thank our sponsors. So what I'm going to do is show their logo and say their name. Let's not clap for each of them. Okay, so when we get to the end, after we've gotten through all of the sponsors, then let's give them a gigantic, rousing round of applause that they can hear down in the booths. Okay? So first, our conference host, the Auckland University of Technology. This is a sponsored event. Conference host is the OWASP New Zealand chapter, of which a few of the leaders are here, and this is run as an OWASP event. A little bit of trivia, because you will notice that there's also EPSEC New Zealand shows up on a lot of the t-shirts. What's the difference? There is no difference. Sort of. The short version of it is, there are two things that the OWASP Foundation has decided. First, chapters are not allowed to incorporate using the OWASP name. Second, they're not going to register for New Zealand GST. So, we incorporated a charity under a slightly different name, EPSEC New Zealand. That organization's entire purpose for existence is to run this conference and pay the bills. So, I am the founder and president of EPSEC New Zealand, which is the conference organizer. And then we're using the OWASP branding under license. So it's an OWASP event, but that's the legal technicality behind the scenes. I remember when we started EPSEC New Zealand a couple years ago, there was that, well, what are you trying to replace OWASP? No, we're trying to deal with the law. Our platinum sponsors, Defend, Fastly, Quantum Security, then we have 8 gold sponsors. They're in alphabetical order. Aura Information Security, Cyber CX, Datacom, the Defense Technology Agency, yeah. Arius Risk. Yes, if you didn't know, I started working for Arius Risk 2 months ago. So yes, we're a sponsor. Planet, bronze sponsors, 2Degrees, I think you might have heard of them, and Safe Advisory. We have a contributing sponsor, Code Crafters. So Code Crafters has very generously donated some VIP lifetime passes for the prize draw tomorrow, as well as a pass to every speaker. So speakers, in your thank you envelopes, you will find a certificate for a VIP lifetime pass to Code Crafters. So this is not a security-specific learning site. It's a site that's focused on helping you to learn how to deploy web applications, figuring out how to make things like Kubernetes work. So it's actually kind of a cool thing that you can use their lab environment and say, well, following their instructions, how insecure is this? And then we cannot forget that we also have a Lego Build sponsor, and yes, that's Arius Risk as well. So now, get ready. Huge, roaring round of applause in 3, 2, 1. Yeah! When you visit them at their booths, please tell them. Thank you. Please let the exhibiting sponsors know how much you appreciate their being here and supporting the conference. As you talk to people who are here from other sponsors, let them know as well. If the company is a sponsor, you'll actually see it at the bottom line of the badge. So for those of you who registered yourselves not using one of the sponsor codes, hopefully I caught it and added it to your badge to show that you're with one of the sponsors. Let them know how much you appreciate it, so they'll keep doing it. And I want to thank our conference organizing committee. On the day of the event, including yesterday and Tuesday during the training, we have a number of people who come and they help us out. But these are the people who put up with having Zoom calls with me on a weekly or fortnightly basis for months. So Annika is doing volunteer herding and doing a masterful job. She's also taken over a lot of the operations organizing that I keep forgetting to do. So I'm going to change her title to operations manager. It's a massive promotion. She gets 3 times the pay. Austin and Jatinder worked with me on organizing the conference program, and Austin took the lead on interacting with speakers and trying to get speaker agreements completed and information for all of them. Lech Jancheski, who was one of the founding organizers of the conference, he's here and he's helping us out with our tech and AV interactions. So if there's a problem in the room, he'll be the one running around trying to find the AV guys. Pete is living his life down at the sponsor desk, so thank him for that, because it can be boring at times, so stop by and have a chat. But sponsors, he's your first point of contact if you've got any issues and needs assistance with anything. And yes, we're still trying to find the missing shipment. Ramandeep helps lead up the reception. We have Noah here. He's a session chair in this room all day. Chris Hardy has been, throughout our getting ready, has been helpful in a number of areas. We've got a number of standout volunteers who've been on site this week, and too many to name, and I forgot to write them down. Sorry. So, all in all, today we've got about 25 volunteers running around. The conference organization, planning and so on, is usually this group of 8 to 10 people, and during the off months, during the off season, it's John sending emails. presenter, please come into the room and meet with your session chair. So it's most all day it's Noah here, and I think all day it's Austin and Trek too. Okay. All right. Okay. So Ramadeep is your session chair for the morning session, and then Austin will be taking the afternoon and tomorrow. So meet with your session chair. Make sure that they know you're there. Try to do a tech check before the session starts if you can. And then before your talk, they'll help you get mic'd up. They also will have a thank you gift for you. So up next, we have our conference keynote. And then after Vandana's keynote address, we split into the tracks. The first talk on deck in track one is Kirk with the OWASP Top 10 overview. And then in WA 220 for track two, we have Pramod with the visibility. Battery's gotten low and turned off. So it's a good thing that I'm ending a couple of minutes early, because I think we need to replace the battery before Vandana can start. All right, so the track two talk, Pramod's talk, is gaining visibility and security of your CI/CD pipelines. So there are lots of talks about security in your pipelines, but he's going to be talking about security of the pipelines. Something which is too often neglected. So, oh, battery, it's dying, help me. So I'm going to wrap this up. We're going to work on getting